Hey guys, my name is Robert. A few days ago, I noticed an update to Superwhisper. This is an AI-powered voice-to-text app that I have mentioned in a few other videos. It's become essential to my everyday tasks. After installing the update, I felt like the results that I was getting from AI were not as good as before. I actually freaked out for a moment because I rely on this app a lot, and at the same time, I think I use it in a way that only few other users do. Like, I really take advantage of the AI side of it. And I love it because it's so versatile and useful in so many ways that could be considered not official. And still, it performs amazing. After testing the new version, I discovered a new AI system prompt that was injected on top of the instructions given by the user. I thought, man, maybe the app will finally be restricted to only dictation and transcription, like so many other similar apps. Well, I am happy to report that I was wrong. I had a few words with Neil, the developer, and he is very understanding of the idea to keep this app versatile. I actually just had to modify some of my AI instructions a bit, and he also did a small readjustment to the prompt, so now it all works great, maybe even better than before. However, this update made me realize that it's important that I share more about this. I believe Superwhisper is extremely underrated and also very misunderstood. For users that are looking for a dictation or transcription tool, well, to be honest, there are several similar apps out there that are also great in this area, and many of them at a lower price point. I think people are realizing that having great quality dictation, which is very fast, is definitely amazing for productivity. So we're seeing a lot of these apps appear everywhere. But what doesn't make a lot of sense to me is that people are not seeing Superwhisper as an AI application itself, or rather, they are not seeing the AI possibilities with it. I do find the price of Superwhisper hard to justify if it will only be used for transcription, but looking at the AI features in it, there's so much value here that is being ignored. I've been thinking about this for a while, and I think there's a conflict between the potential of the app and its user base. There's a lot that Superwhisper can currently do, and it could do so much more, but most of the users are only using it for something very basic. Then, since many of the users do not understand the AI side of it, there are issues, confusion, or frustrations that arise from this in a way that I think could affect the direction of development. Instead of adding more control or allowing users more advanced features, well, the app could be simplified more and more with every update just to accommodate for the most common use cases. So, I'm taking it as a part of a personal mission not to let this app become a simple, yes, powerful and fast, but in the end, just a simple dictation and transcription app. There are already so many of those available, and I'm sure that more will continue to appear. However, I don't see anything else in the AI arena that can currently compare to Superwhisper. There has to be one AI app that is incredibly fast in receiving voice commands from the user. This app must give absolute freedom of use and control for AI through specific user instructions. This app has to support sending context of what you have on your screen or clipboard, and this app must include not only local models, but access to some of the latest Claude or OpenAI models at no extra cost or without using the user's API tokens. And on top of all of this, this app must offer a lifetime option as a one-time payment, not only a subscription. Until an app like this appears, in my opinion, Superwhisper has no real competition out there. Honestly, this is a too good to be true kind of application. I've been using it for several months already, and I can see the commitment from Neil, the developer. I think that this lifetime option, as we're seeing it right now, is something that could potentially change anytime because the models that are included are very good, and of course, they cost recurring fees. So it makes sense to me that the price could go up anytime, or on the other hand, the lifetime option could be removed. Now, Neil continues to work on this, making the app better update after update. I am very grateful that until now he's still open for the app to be used with this freedom that I'm talking about. However, I think that the future direction of Superwhisper depends on all of us. The features that are requested, the thoughts or ideas that users express, and overall, the use that people are giving this. I wanted to share these thoughts because I plan to make more videos about Superwhisper and how I use it. I don't plan to make this channel only about this, and I know many of you guys that follow may not be interested in this app at all, but it's such a powerful tool that can benefit so many users in ways they have no idea. And if we can all somehow level up together, and the developer can notice this, well, I believe this application can become even more powerful. So, what can you do with this that I'm telling you? First of all, I encourage you to join the community over at Discord. Ask questions, request or discuss features, share the things that you would like to see, or ask how people are using it for your particular use case. Maybe someone else can give you some tips. If you see other users with questions that you know the answers to, help them. If you run into any bugs or issues, now there's a specific way to report them. I'll be giving you a link for you to use this method so that the developer can address the issues and continue improving the app faster. Now, in regards to using the app itself, if all of these I've been talking about sounds interesting and you have not tried Superwhisper yet, you get access to 15 minutes of the pro features as a trial. I suggest that you use them for more than simple dictation and transcription. The app is incredible at dictation, for sure. It definitely is at the top of the game. The latest Ultra Cloud voice model is the fastest I have ever seen. To use this for dictation alone, without any additional processing, you would be creating a voice-only mode. Ultra Cloud is super accurate, and it also hallucinates like crazy, but that is mostly fixed if you select the silence removal toggle in the configuration under the advanced settings. So make sure to select that if you experience some extra random words being inserted when you did not dictate them. Aside from the simple voice mode, you have different preset modes. These have AI processing, but they are meant to be used, again, in a dictation transcription kind of scenario. They will each format what you speak to your computer in a specific way. Down here, there's some information about each of them. And by the way, if you haven't downloaded any models, you will only have cloud options, but you can download or add more in the tab on the sidebar. I'll say that each different AI model, either for voice or for processing, has advantages or disadvantages. Some are faster, some are slower, some are more accurate, some are smarter. For most of my Superwhisper modes, I currently use Ultra Cloud for voice, and for AI processing, if it's a simple formatting request, I will use GPT-40 Mini because it's fast, but for tasks that require better reasoning, I will go with Sonnet 3.5. With Supermode, we start to see some of the interesting things that this app has to offer because, as it says here, it intelligently adapts to your current application context. But still, it is mostly a mode to format your text following the same common use case. What I think is the most powerful of all of this, and for me, what I consider the true super mode, well, it is a custom mode because here you have absolute control of what you want AI to do for you. This is what I suggest that you try more and experiment with. Specifically, all the options available once you enter the change prompt menu. Don't leave the instructions up here empty, or it will default to simple transcription. In this part of the application where things start to get a little bit more advanced, I think it's super useful to learn a bit about how AI prompting works. It's useful to give it an identity, for example. It helps if you are very specific with the results you are looking for or the context in which you will be using this AI. It's useful to tell it specifically what things not to do or what you are expecting. It can also be very helpful to provide some examples down here. And don't limit yourself to only one custom mode for every kind of task. Make multiple ones that are specialized in different things. It's not my intention to make this video about how AI prompting works, but I have one prompt that I use sort of as a mods creator. I will be giving you the instructions and examples I use for it. With this, you can pretty much just dictate a little bit of what you need, and it will give you a very good starting point for you to further customize. For example, I need one AI that I will use to develop ideas for articles on personal growth. As a result, you will get several lines with a very good instruction that you can copy-paste into another custom mode. Of course, I still suggest that you go over this and remove or add things depending on what you need. In this example that I just gave you, I dictated a few words, but if you are more specific about what you need, the results that you get back will also be much better. It's useful not only for assistant kinds of AI, it's also pretty good for creating modes that will format your text in a specific way, as some of the other presets that you get in Superwhisper already. Now, if you feel like there's already one preset that is already very good for your specific use case and you're happy with it, but there's something you would like to add or modify, there is something you can do. First, create a mode with that preset. Then switch to that mode you just created. Here I'm using the Alfred workflow for that, but you can do it with the app itself. Dictate anything just as a quick test, and then go to your Superwhisper folder, which by default is in the Documents folder. In there, there's a Recordings folder. The last one on the list will have the audio file you just dictated and the meta JSON file. This JSON file has the prompt of the mode that you just used. You can also see this within the history menu of Superwhisper itself down here. I just personally feel this is too small. I have Peek, which is an extension for Finder, and this allows me to quick look these files with color highlighting that is easier to read. Another thing you can do if you have Alfred and get the Alfred workflow that I created for Superwhisper is that you can simply trigger an Alfred action, look for Superwhisper, and you have this super clean text view. Whatever method you use, you will be able to see the preset prompts. You can copy this into a custom mode and change the instructions to fit your needs. Just keep in mind that you only need to copy this text between the instruction tags and put it in your custom instructions. Then, depending on the mode, you may also need to create some examples that you can grab from within the respective XML tags. The JSON files themselves are very useful to learn how Superwhisper works or what is being sent to AI or how it's being formatted. That is why I thought it was important that I included something like this clean text view inside the Alfred workflow, because it can facilitate learning for users. So take advantage of this. These two toggles here are also extremely powerful because they are the ones that allow you to send text back to AI, whether it's for asking a specific instruction on it, or if you want a text that you have on your clipboard to be formatted in a specific way. Sometimes I select and copy an email that I received, and this helps AI to format my response in a specific way. For situations like this and many more, these two options are very useful. I will not dive deep here into how they work because the cases here are so extensive. One thing that I do want to mention here is that this first toggle, the Use Application Context one, works great on input fields, including note applications. So in a more traditional AI application or website, you will normally be exchanging information through an interface similar to a messaging app. But with this toggle, you have the opportunity to look at a note as if it was your workspace or your canvas where you can be communicating with AI. This, together with custom instructions, is crazy powerful. Seriously. It's what makes Superwhisper expand beyond the possibilities of voice only, since you can now type or paste things in your note, then dictate something on top of it, like, please help me out with this, and then AI can assist you right away. I have published another video where I cover a little bit of how I use Superwhisper, taking advantage of this. I created some Keyboard Maestro macros that allow me to send back and forth information with AI in an easy way. One thing I need to mention is that the latest version, which is 1.44.1, breaks a lot of the functionality of my Keyboard Maestro macros that I mentioned in that video. Like I said, I was also a bit worried that these extra functionalities or possibilities of using the app in this way could be totally closed, but something better is coming soon. Don't worry. I'll keep you posted on that. The Alfred workflow continues to work without issues, and you can use it to trigger recordings, quickly change modes, or you can use the snippets included in there to insert your last request, your last result, or even the entire interaction, including your system prompt. I hope everything I have talked about in this video is still useful. I use Superwhisper not only for writing or structuring articles, but also for idea generation, for knowledge management, like summarizing or extracting insights from content, for some coding and creation of Alfred workflows. I use it to assist me when creating automations around my system, and I also use it as a trigger for several automations. For example, I can start my dictation with make note, and then I can talk about any idea that comes to my mind while I'm on my computer. I can do a stream of consciousness on anything that I would like to empty my mind from. And this is really useful because I really dislike it when ideas escape from me. But at the same time, I also want to stay focused on what I'm doing. So Superwhisper allows me a quick solution for this. Once I finish dictating, I can move on to something else. Later, when I open my notes application, my note is already there, with both my raw thoughts and some outlined key points. For this, I actually use my AI memos automation that I talk about in another video. I connected that to Superwhisper. I have been trying to come up with a plan on how to take you guys from basic to more advanced stuff. I will for sure cover different use cases, and when the functionality of the Keyboard Maestro macros gets restored, I'll probably do a deep dive for that so you can learn how to customize it more. Once the macros are back up running with a future version of Superwhisper, I will probably mention it in my newsletter, or I will post a comment in this video. So just letting you know. If you have any ideas on how to go about exploring more of this app, I'd appreciate it if you let me know. I just don't want to go crazy advanced and scare away more casual users. Instead, I want to show everyone more how they can benefit from using this in ways that are only limited by their creativity. Because honestly, I don't think I've ever seen an app that is so powerful to be so underutilized and underrated. So, like I said, join the Discord server, express your interest in using this app beyond simple dictation or transcription, try to learn more about prompting, explore the JSON files, play more with custom modes, experiment with app context in a note, and share your thoughts with me. Oh, and remember that I will be giving you that character creator prompt in the description of the video. Once more, let me clarify, this is not becoming a Superwhisper only channel. There's other stuff coming up too, so don't worry if this isn't your thing. Remember, you can always sign up to my newsletter for more up-to-date news on what I'm up to. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I'll talk to you soon.